Getting close. Hope mentioned seeing some tracks in the mud. See if you can find them. Found them? Great. Snap some pictures for the record and see if they lead anywhere. Yeah, definitely human. Looks like a troublemaker then. Now, I don't want you to go picking any fights, but maybe you could follow them and see where they lead. Some ripped clothing. And no more tracks, huh? Well, just leave it for now, and I'll see what I can come up with. This'll help, though. Thanks. I'm still looking into that incident at Hope's camp. I spoke with him and he wanted me to pass on his thanks. He's been having some problems finding food lately though. The black-tailed deer are surprisingly scarce in Belmont for this time of year. Now Hope seems to think some black bears are passing through and scaring off the blacktails. Could be true, but it's hard to know for sure. If you come by any bear tracks in Belmont, let me know. High Lake and the neighboring Balmont region contain the lowlands of the Lake District. Stuck between Mount Kraken and Northern Ridge, the Hatton River Delta formed from cascading rainwater and snowmelt down the mountainsides. Oh, and don't forget to spot the unique rock formations in this area. You won't find anything else like it in the Pacific Northwest.
Thank you.
Blacktail's are Hope's bread and butter. If you ever want hunting tips on him, he's your man. He's been with the Blacktails for a while now. If they're on the move, it's not only a problem for Hope, it might mean worrying changes for other parts of the reserve. Look at that. You found a shed. I've already got a big enough collection back home, so I've started selling any new ones I find. People often buy them for handicrafts, you know. Knife handles and such. I once sold a really nice moose antler for $500. Want to stay busy on the road, I'd keep a lookout for sheds. You know, antlers that are shed by the reserve animals? They're rare to find and very popular to collect.